You ever get those cufflinks you wanted?
Everybody, and welcome back to Purple Plays Bully. In the last episode, In the last episode, we, did a couple
missions.
You know
you should try the new
Aquabury
vest. Very popular with the better class of students.
Don't tell me what to wear, although I actually need to do this. We did the missions Hattrick versus Galloway. We did last minute shopping, and we got to look at the new shop and photography classes, as well as doing one of the chores for money we can do. And in this episode, I am going to access this shop. This is a special shop because it only has two items you can really buy. An Aquaberry vest and an Aquaberry sweater. These are actually mandatory things that you need to get. You don't need to get both of them, you just need to get one of them. So pick whichever one you like the most, and yeah. I'm gonna get the sweater because I think the sweater's cooler than just the vest.
Goodbye, and thank you for choosing Aquaberry.
And not over bad. Here, you'll get a rubber band. So there's that. The reason I say you need an Aquaberry vest is because you will not be allowed inside the boxing gym otherwise. I also think that you also require a haircut too, so I'm gonna go ahead and get the haircut as well. I hope I don't
need
it.
We brave fade. What you want?
But I'll get it just in case. Unless they're all the same. Are they all the same? No, these are different. We got the good boy, the Hollywood, the heartthrob. Oh, wow. The short and shaggy. Maybe they are the same. No, they're not. There's the smart, the Ivy League, and that's it. The smart does look nice, but then again, it's sort of short and shaggy. I might just go with this. If you use the left and right arrows, you can actually change the color of what hairstyle you want. It usually just goes down more and more until you get to copper, where it goes all the way back up. As much as I despise chocolate as a candy, I do prefer as a hair color. That's actually not a bad look. How about in chestnut? I'm gonna get the short and shaggy. Like I said, I don't think you actually really need a haircut, but I'm doing it just in case. I know for a fact you do need one of the Aquaberry vests or sweaters, so make sure you have enough money for that. I don't know why I'm taking this bike. Yeah, my bike is right over there. Although I think they're the same, actually. Huh. Go figure. Yeah, they are the same. Okay. That's nice to know. Anyways, so the first thing I'm gonna do, because it's one of the only things we can do right now, is the prep challenge, which is right over here at the boxing gym. This is an optional mission, but I recommend doing it whenever possible. You can start the boxing challenger. I think you can earn some money, but I don't know for sure. This is where the challenge is.
Maybe I can use this to my advantage.
Get it to him! Come on!
The losers are
I wanna see some blood!
We want blood!
Be glad I don't enter the frame.
So here we have a first person view. And it's gonna be a little different than what we normally do. We hold L1 to block, and we have free range of movements. We have access to a 5-hit combo. And what you want to do is obviously knock him out.
I can do so much better, you know?
You can telegraph their moves and go for a dodge, and then follow up with that. To break their guard,
you're such a wimp.
Yeah, so if they're guarding, you want to do a charge. Oh, wow.
Like my shoes, they're genuine puppy leather.
And it'll break the guard. Charge attacks break guard.
Move like a beast.
When you see an opening like that, you want to dodge it to get a free combo.
$50
says that Hopkins is going to bite it.
Oh, don't worry. Jimmy's tough.
Hopkins is surprisingly tough.
Holding the button will also do the knockout punch, which is what you really want to do, but only at the end. I could be wrong on the charge attack breaking the guard, though. But I just tried it and it didn't work. But I digress. That was one challenger in the form of Chad. Now I have Justin. We have to fight three preps in order to win the challenge. Ah, damn.
That looks like it hurt!
I am not doing so well. But then again, this isn't too hard.
Don't worry! Jimmy's tough!
Show some spirit, man!
I'm just going like this. I'll take a punch.
That's the best you can do!
I got him in the corner. I have him on the ropes. Literally, I have him on the ropes.
Hopkins, you're pathetic!
Yeah, I'm pathetic, and I knocked him out in one round. I recommend doing this challenge...
Doubt.
Immediately, kind of, or sometime before you get to the last mission of chapter 2, because you're going to have to do this this boxing mini game at the end. You'll have to do this mini game on the final mission of the prep.
So
it's best to get some practice in now, because this can be a bit challenging at times if you're not. Although, at the same time, this isn't very much practice because these guys are really big pushovers compared to the person you have to fight in the final mission. But the formula is the same. Stay down. Damn it. Also, whenever a new round starts, both you and your opponent recover a bit of health, so keep that in mind.
It's a wonder Hopkins is still standing.
It is a wonder,
so much better, you know?
Three preps in one
That's
match.
The best you can do!
I should be tired, but I'm not. You guys are all a bunch of pushovers.
I always knew I could.
Alright, I won! Give me my prize!
There's a little problem. Your parents have to be members of the board for you to be eligible. Tell you what, old chap, we'll give you that old abandoned beach house. Should be nice once you clean it up.
So instead of getting $1 million, we get a beach house, which to them is a piece of crap, but it's really a nice place. So, whenever you complete a challenge, you actually get a new base, or a new dorm room, more or less. I should have just said a new save location, because that's basically what it is. Also, by doing the prep challenge, we unlock the boxing outfit. Unfortunately, we don't get the gloves to go
done
with it, which
and
sucks,
done right.
But whatever. You don't want to take off the Aquaberry vest yet, because you will need it for a future mission, too. So I'm going to hold on to it for a little bit. I think the mission is called the Eggs. Could be mistaken. Also, you don't really want to ride any transportation on the beach because it's going to be really hard maybe the skateboard. But the bikes, unless you get a dirt bike, it won't do very well on the beach, I don't think. But with that, we have a new save location, which also means a new bed, I mean, honestly, this place isn't too bad. I mean, I can't say how good the bed looks, but you got a sofa, we got paddles, which don't do anything because we can't bring them outside. We have a bar. A little table. Even a soda machine.
I can feel my insides rotting already.
Good for you. And we even have our own closet, a fireplace, and we even have our own game system. Which, by the way, you can play these. I'm just not gonna bother right now. I'll probably show it off later. But with that, what I'll do next is probably meet you guys over where the paper routes are. So I'll see you in just a bit. Oh, what's this now?
Listen, pal, help a poor, desperate fella out.
I love crabs.
Definitely.
Thank you, kind.
Okay, so originally I was going to do the bike thing. Not the bike thing. Well, it is a bike thing. I was going to do the paper route, but now this guy has requested that I get him some crabs. So what I'm going to do is show you another mechanic. Swimming! Which, just like bike riding, is nothing different. Because you can just casually swim. You can hold the X button down, or you can mash it to get even faster. I mean, why wouldn't you want to mash it unless you just rather take the toll off your thumb and just hold it. Or if you don't want to hear this all the time. I try to keep it as quiet as I can. Well, in terms of for my commentary. Just so that you guys aren't annoyed with. But I don't know if that helps all too well. Or if I'm able to conceal it well. Over here, we'll find other grottos and gremlins cards. Oh, there's 40 of them. I thought there was only 10. Huh. Oh well. 40 it is. I've never collected all of them, so I don't know what happens if you get them all. Right now is Art 4. I at least want to get to Gym 5 just to beat it, because it's the most obnoxious class to get to next to Shop. But it's more obnoxious because it's farther away. Okay, but once you get all the crabs, and also this is an errand that's on a time limit, unlike most others that are not. Oh, I got this guy. I don't know what he's doing. I think you can fight him, but I don't know. I usually don't try and fight adults. If you fight an adult, that's like fighting a prefect or a cop. And yes, there are cops in this game, and they act just like prefects. Although adults, I don't know, they're a little iffy. They don't really attack you all that often. They insult you a lot, but they don't like bust you or anything. And make sure you remember where this guy is.
Is this what you're looking for?
A friend in need is a friend indeed, friend.
Alright, we're friends. And he gave me $20. Not bad. Okay, so I'll see you guys over at the paper route.
I won't be able to go alone.
Oh, it's actually right over here, so never mind.
Hey kid, do you want to earn some money delivering papers?
Sounds all right.
Okay, get the papers and deliver them all, but don't be late.
All right, so now we have paper, or newspapers. Do I have them selected? Oh, nope, I have to collect them first. Okay, so I think we have an unlimited amount. Basically, hold the R1 button just like you would be throwing something, and you'll automatically lock on to these things, to the mailboxes. Once you see the reticle, just go ahead and toss it. It'll home in pretty well. You can throw them at people too, I think. Nope. Well, you might be able to if you're really good at it. I don't recommend it. And yes, a dog will chase you. Aw, damn it. Oh, did I get it? I didn't get it. I must admit, I think it just counted the last one and just said screw it. Because I got $14 instead of a more solid number like 15. But with that, class is over for art, but gym will be coming up. So I'll see you guys in, I think, gym 5. Oh, and here's another rubber band.
I can use that.
Alright. Oh. Sorry, dog. But I didn't hit you, you hit me. Alright, I'll see you guys in just a sec.
Alright, you feckless maggots. We'll be playing dodgeball for the next while. Ah, dodgeball. How I love the sound of boys crying in the morning. Much like real life, the strongest will prevail. All right, you lazy bums, look alive! Good! Hopkins, you're with the wimps. I want everyone to give their best, boys, their best!
So, it's nothing different from all the other rounds. The difference is that we have harder opponents in the form of jocks.
But try not to lose this time, guy!
So...
You forget that I'm an expert!
You better be ready to lose, because I'm ready to win!
Oh, wow. Damn it. Okay.
We got the power of friendship behind our team!
Oh. Algae, show that strength.
Ugh. Who's on top? We're on top!
Alright, that's one win for me. Yeah, jocks have a lot better AI in this. They can be really tricky. Also, whenever you, win the struggle with the ball, usually you can just press X and get an easy elimination. So that's nice.
Hopkins, you passed my class. Come back whenever you feel like teaching these wimps a few things.
That's how it's done.
And now we have the best accuracy for our weaponry. And we can also start dodgeball from the boys' changing room. So if you ever wanted to play dodgeball against, you know, preps, greasers, and all that stuff, you can do that. It's a nice little thing. It should be noted that when you complete a class, you can still come back to it, but you won't gain anything. It's just to kill time, really. Oh, I got red low tops. But, okay, guys, piss off.
I'm gonna lay your butt
but yeah,
like
you don't really gain
boyfriend.
Anything for it.
You're going down,
man, jocks are real assholes. I hate being in this area because jocks are actually pretty tough to take down. They hit hard and they take a beating, so there's a reason why it's best to avoid them. Early on in the game, at least until you're ready.
I mean you.
Jeez, get out of my way. Alright, but with that out of the way, I was gonna do movie tickets, but I'm actually wanting to do the eggs because I wanna get out of this damn Aquaberry vest immediately. I wanna wear something else. So I'll see you guys back at the boxing gym.
Broke nobody.
Alright, so now that we're... Okay, you wanna go? Aw, oh, he just egged me. Okay, not cool, man.
Shorty, I've got your back. I'm not even trying.
Neither am I.
Ow! You just ruined my puberty for me.
Oh, he's actually dodging me. Yeah, the thing about preps when you're fighting them is that they are well-trained boxers.
I don't know why they say...
At least some of them are, and someone just egged his own guy. Ugh, go down already, bitch. Let me grab you. Damn it. Wow, look at that dodge.
I'm gonna beat.
Oh god. Man, this guy really is tough. I think this is the guy you fight at the last dub. In the last mission of this chapter. This is what I was alluding to in the last episode, but you don't fight him like this. You fight him in the ring.
Oh, am I hurting your feelings?
And I just need him. And with you. Oh, wow, he actually broke out of that a lot sooner than I thought. Just gonna spit on your face. And now I'm going to do what I do best, and that is missions. If you don't come here with the Aquaberry vest, then there'll be a prep that'll stop you and just tell you that you are a dirty mark and you do not deserve to be here.
Look, there he is. I was wondering if you'd show up, Hopkins. Nice Aquaberry sweater. Trey Sheik.
Yeah.
Wow. You look a bit like my gardener at home.
Yeah, so what?
Yes, well, enough about gardeners or any domestic help. Listen. Me and the chaps were planning a little revenge hit on old Hattrick. We don't like what he did to that old Soap Galloway. A chap could have a drink if he bloody hell wants to.
So?
So, my friend, are you, as they say, in?
Sure. Are you English?
Well, no. I just speak this way because I'm very insecure. You see, my father is a self-made man, so I pretend to be old money, but in fact, I'm really nouveau riche. But less about me, dear boy. Listen, we're going to egg that old codger's house.
Cool.
Smashing! You go get some eggs and meet me and the chaps back at my house.
This is what I was talking about in one of the later parts. These characters are just so much fun. If only they'd stop being complete assholes. Just gonna... hit you in the nuts.
Why did you have to do that?
Because you tried to attack me. So, what was the thing? Take your eggs to Tad's house. If you already have eggs, then you don't have to go to the market to go buy some. All you need to do now is just head over to Tad's house. The reason why I didn't go get the bike is because I wanted to snitch a ride on to the back of that car. Sorry, I got some gas building up and burping, almost got ran over, although I don't think you can get run over. And over here you can get a free carton of eggs too, so there's no reason to buy any, so don't. And as you saw when I beat up that big dude, he dropped a no, it wasn't him, it was another prep. Preps usually carry around cartons of eggs, so buying them again is pointless, just like bouquets. Although bouquets of flowers are much easier to get. I could take your bike, but I don't feel like it. That just land me in a whole bunch of trouble.
Means a lot of backstabbing.
So go over here and we'll begin the mission.
Got the eggs, Hopkins?
You bet.
Then give them to me. Take them. Smashing. Now tell me, Hopkins, is it true you said I was inbred?
No.
Because first cousins is legal, my friend. Legal.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, and just because my elder brother doesn't have a chin and ended up in a lunatic asylum, it doesn't mean anything.
Whatever, Tad. Your family is your business.
Don't lie, Jimmy. You said Tad was probably a hermaphrodite with that much inbreeding.
A hermaphro what?
Don't act dumb. You said his mom was also legally his aunt, and that he probably had webbed toes.
I don't... well, just only on one foot.
Tad, you're not gonna take that kind of crap from this scumbag, are you?
You've been rude about mommy! Let's get this pauper! Inbred!
Poor Tad.
I guess I must beat you.
He's really funny, just really stupid, too. Oh, I was gonna spit on him, too.
I'll put you in your place.
Oh, okay. Alright, that takes care of one. I'm gonna tackle you. Via combo, and... uppercut. Okay, who's the asshole that's egging me? There he is. Take you down. Oh, you reversed it. He does not want me to knee him in the balls. One thing I want to show off, if I can, is a little trick with the eggs. But then again, I need to show off taunting altogether.
Don't you wish you had...
Okay, usually you can taunt people, but... Oh, wow, that was a really good hit. Ah, damn it. Usually you can taunt people by giving them the thumbs down or shoving them. But if you have an egg equipped, you can smash an egg right in their face. It's really fun. It's like the ultimate disrespect. And with that, we actually not only passed that, oh wow, I'm actually being chased. But now we have cartons of eggs in our dorm, so it's even easier to get eggs than before. Although eggs are mainly just for egging houses and other missions, which I think is going to be coming into play soon, so there's that.
I won't be able to go it alone. I'm going to need your help, man.
Oh, this is actually another unique errand. Make food deliveries. Now with this, we actually get, well, minimum wage outfit. And a fries piece hat, which is the crowning jewel, if I do say so myself.
Here you go.
I don't know who delivers food like that, but whatever. What I recommend you do is get something like a bike, that way you can actually do this and not get attacked like I'm doing. Okay.
Not so big now, are you?
He's gonna take care of him.
Sneak into a girl's locker room?
I'm just gone. Oh, and there's another rubber band. Oh god, I'm actually gonna run out of time if I don't hurry. Alright. Here you go.
This what you're looking for?
Thanks a lot, Jimmy.
Here's a whole lot of nothing.
Loser!
Wow.
Give me a bike, you scout.
Hey!
Just chill.
That is mine.
That was my bike. You look ridiculous. I'm
trying to take my bike like that. Don't be saying I'm being a thief. That was my bike. I can prove it. Sort of. Not really. Anyways, just make 3 deliveries, and all these lovely clothes and more are yours.
Here you go.
A friend in need is a friend indeed, friend.
Oh man, it's the crab guy. And I get 25 bucks out of that. It's not too bad. I think it's a little more than what minimum wage actually gets you, but I mean, I'd love that. And with that, I think I'm going to go ahead and I'm not going to end the episode just yet. That'll be after I do one more mission. I'm going to jam-pack this episode as much as possible. So, I'll see you guys in just a bit for movie tickets. Here we are at movie tickets. Without further ado.
Hey, Jimmy Hopkins.
Do I know you?
No, I'm Pinky, but I know all about you. Everybody's talking about you. Everybody says that you're mean and angry and you like fighting.
Huh.
Gary said you're so mad because you're sexually confused.
Yeah, well, Gary talks a lot of crap.
Oh, I know. I don't like him. He likes to torture people.
So what? He's not gonna torture me.
Well, I'm glad you're not sexually confused.
Really?
Yeah. I like you, Jimmy Hopkins.
Oh, yeah?
But I need you to do something for me.
What a surprise.
I'm last in line, and this movie means everything to me. I'm gonna get terrible seats. Can you please get rid of all these people for me? Please, Jimmy?
What's in it for me?
I'm a princess,
oh.
And I need people to do things for me. So hurry up.
man. All right.
And that's the gist of this one. This isn't really a hard mission. It's kind of funny in a way. So, first thing to get people out of line is to steal Gord's bike. And just go away. He actually has a really good bike.
It's just not fair.
At least from what I can tell.
I don't see why something like this should happen.
And that takes care of Lola as well. Yeah, it's got really good acceleration from what I can tell. You don't have to go that far, just enough to where they'll all run out.
Yeah.
Run away. And with that, let's take care of the next person in line. Eunice.
Hey.
Have you got it yet? So I was thinking. Never mind. See ya.
I thought you might like these.
So all you do is just flirt with her
Thanks,
once.
Thanks, Jim. Seriously, thank
and
you.
And then you walk to a secluded area.
Oh, no!
All you do is just walk over here. And no, you can't really get any faster. Well, actually, yeah, you can. Just press X and you'll, like, sprint a little, I guess.
I'll remember this forever!
Just like you remembered it the first time? Huh. Anyways, we got
I just wanna
Trent and Kirby.
Sports, that's all.
They are actually gay.
That's great,
so I guess
Jimmy.
They just don't like to be
if
confronted.
If only I'd been born into my social circle.
Well, I do have a few uses, you know.
Oh, really? Well, you know, nice girls like nice flowers. Anyway, here's some money. It's the least I could do. And it's Daddy's, anyways. The show's about to start, but come see me sometime. We can work through these class issues we have.
Oh, I'll work through your class issues all right, sweetie.
And with that, we take care of another prep mission.
That's that nonsense,
on their, queen, more or less. And over here, we have a Grottos and Gremlins card.
I'm just gonna collect this.
Makes another one, and now we have a possessed bike. Should I touch it? Yes, I should. Because it's my possessed bike now. Teleporting cops everywhere. Am I sure I'm not playing a mod? Because I feel like I'm playing a mod. Oh, shop too. I'm just gonna go ahead and do shop 2 real quick and then I'm gonna end the episode. I'm also gonna show this
off. Have you ever dated someone who kept their...
This is a bus stop.
Sure, it's okay.
This is basically your quick travel way from getting to, from the city to school. Especially if you want to hit something over at the school. Whether it's a mission or if it's a,
toilet stand. Check it out, fool.
Damn it. If it's a mission or if it's a class, it's really helpful. Oh wait, no, I want to go over here. I think class ends.
Get
at
the class, you little turd.
Did you just call me a turd? Because I will stuff his ass in the garbage.
All right, kids, I'm in a crap mood today, so just shut up and get to work.
Right. And now for our second bike.
Good work, Hopkins.
I think all these are the same. They just... No, never mind. I take that back. Take that
Not
back.
Not too shabby, Hopkins.
It's always different. Well, sort of. Like
Shutting
chemistry, it's
working.
Always the same way you're doing it. It's just a different, you know,
okay.
way of
See
going
you next
about
time,
it.
Jim.
If that makes any sense. If anything, shop just only adds one step further, whereas in chemistry they add like a whole bunch of more buttons.
Did you see that?
And with that we get our new bike, which is a little better than our last one. So that's nice.
And done.
And done indeed, just like I am done with this episode. Well, that's nice. So, next time on Purple Plays Bully, What other missions do we have? There's none that are activated right now. It's actually still morning. But anyways, next time on Bully, we're probably going to be interfering with more of the prep's business, getting into a whole bunch of altercations and such. And we may even do a side quest or not. I don't know. I think I'm just going to focus on story missions for the next part. Because there's really not much going on. I may dive into more of the paper route and the lawn mowing. I think the paper route's only good in the morning, and then lawn mowing can be whenever throughout the day, as long as it's not at night, I guess. One more thing to note is that unlike your other save locations, your dorm room is the only one that has a chem set, so
it was a tiger, not a crane.
There is still a reason to come back to the school if only for that. But that's pretty much about it, so yeah, next part will be pretty much nothing but story, unless I can find something else to do. Maybe even finish up another class. But I'll see you guys next time.